Atmospheric Administration, the founder of Our Daily Planet, Monica Medina. Monica, good to see you again. Thank you for being with us.
Thanks, Ellie. It's great to be here today. Thanks for having me.
I think there are lots of reasons why reasonable people might have criticisms about the Green New Deal or whether they can price it out properly or what it's going to cost. I'm fascinated that Donald Trump thinks that he should keep this alive so that he can run against it. It's a bit bizarre. The president of the United States is banking on a win from voters for his party by going against policies that would benefit the environment.
I know, it's crazy. I never agree with the president on this one. I totally agree. Let's keep the Green New Deal in the conversation for the election because I think it's a winner for Democrats. 80% of all Americans want clean air, clean water, safe drinking water, and clean power, clean energy from wind and solar. Those are not divisive issues in our country. There is overwhelming agreement in red states, in blue states, north, south, east, west, everywhere. That's what the public wants. So if the president wants to run on his record on those things, bring it on.
All right, so 27% of Americans do not accept climate change. About 23% of Americans think that Barack Obama was a Kenyan-born Muslim. About 24% of Americans think that we walk amongst aliens. So I guess it's not crazy that 27% don't accept that the world is warming. What is crazy is that why are Republicans completely not in sync with that number, that 73% of Americans who actually do believe in it?
I personally don't understand it at all, and I think actually this is going to be a very difficult issue for a lot of Republicans who are up for election in 2020. A lot of those senators in places like Colorado or in Florida or North Carolina are going to be running from this issue because even they now admit that climate change is happening. You can't look around us. But even in the Midwest, think about it. There are millions of people who are being affected by those floods. Kansas City's water was potentially contaminated over the weekend. A million people have water that they get for drinking from drinking wells, and those are potentially contaminated. These issues are everywhere. People see them and they know them. I think it's why it's starting to take root in the country. People want to talk about them. The candidates get asked about them everywhere they go. So I think the Republicans are kidding themselves, and the vote in the Senate yesterday was just, I think, going to make them look bad in the end because they didn't even give the issue any kind of serious consideration. It was just, you know, Senator Lee and his posters.
Yeah, with about having
Seriously.
More kids and the EPA administrator, the boss of the EPA, saying we don't need to really worry about this. It's 50 to 75 years out. Monica, we'll have more time. We have lots of time to discuss this, and we will use it well. Monica, thank you so much. Monica Medina.
I look forward to it.
She's
keep it up.
The founder of Our Daily Planet, former NOAA deputy principal. Deputy Undersecretary of Commerce for Oceans and Atmospheric in the atmosphere. All right, 12 days in prison after pleading guilty for lying to Robert Mueller. But was former campaign aide George Papadopoulos lying again when he talked about the special counsel?